Hola y bienvenido a Learn Spanish en SpanishDict.com. Soy Paraly Whitmire y soy tu profesora. Hoy aprenderás el condicional y las excusas, como iría al cine, pero no tengo dinero. Estudiaríamos japonés, pero no tenemos tiempo. Y mucho más. ¡Vámonos! Cuando quieres hablar de una posibilidad o una situación hipotética en español, se usa un tenso especial, el condicional. También el condicional es perfecto para las excusas. Mira unos ejemplos y busca las semejanzas al futuro que aprendiste en la última lección. El condicional y el futuro tienen mucho en común. Presta atención al raíz de los verbos. Profesora, haría el examen, pero estoy enferma. Professor, I would take the exam, but I'm sick. Lavarías los platos, pero tus amigos vinieron. You would wash the plates, but your friends came over. Correría en una carrera, pero no le gusta hacer ejercicio. She would run in a race, but she doesn't like to exercise. Estudiaríamos más para el examen, pero tenemos sueño. We would study more for the exam, but we are sleepy. Iríais a la feria, pero no tenéis dinero. You would go to the fair, but you don't have any money. Saldrían ahora, pero está lloviendo. They would leave now, but it is raining. ¿Lo ves? Veamos estos verbos del condicional al lado de los mismos verbos en el futuro. Haría, haré. Lavarías, lavarás. Correría, correrá. Estudiaríamos, estudiaremos. Iríais, iréis. Saldrían, saldrán. What do each of these pairs have in common? They all have the same stem. The conditional uses the infinitive for the stem for regular verbs, just like the future. Lavar, correr, estudiar, and ir. It also has the exact same irregular verbs and their stems as the future. Hacer stem is still H-A-R, and salir stem is still S-A-L-D-R. So if you know your future irregulars, you know your conditional irregulars. All you have to do is learn the endings. But there's a secret. You already know the endings. Let's take away the verb stems for all the conditional verbs, and you tell me if you recognize anything. Ia, ias, ia, íamos, íais, ían. Look familiar? They are the exact same endings as the indicative imperfect tense for ER and IR verbs. So, to form the conditional, take the future stem, which is the infinitive, and add the endings for what tense? The imperfect. Now, I know it's been a while since we've talked about ER and IR imperfect endings. So, are you ready for a mini quiz? Very basic. I will ask you the ending for a specific person, and you just give me the ending. I will show you what a verb would look like in both tenses, the imperfect and the conditional, so you can see what a difference the verb stem makes in meaning. ¿Listo? ¿Cuál es la terminación para tú? Ías, comías, you used to eat. Comerías, you would eat. Remember, the conditional is used to express what would happen in the future. It is a possibility or a hypothetical situation. It is not the same as when we use would in English to talk about the past. In Spanish, to talk about what you would do or used to do in the past, you use the imperfect. So while the translations can be the same, comías, you would eat, and comerías, you would eat. The first one means you used to eat in the past, and the second one uses would in a hypothetical situation to talk about what you could or might eat. Okay, next question. ¿Cuál es la terminación para nosotros? Íamos, corríamos, we used to run. Correríamos, we would run. ¿Y para yo? Ía, bebía, I used to drink. Bebería, I would drink. Él, ella y usted. Ía, podía. He, she, or you used to be able. Podría. He, she, or you would be able. Vosotros. Íais. Hacíais. You used to make. Haríais. You would make. ¿Y ellos, ellas y ustedes? Ian, tenían, they used to have. Tendrían, they would have. Super fácil, ¿no? Just use the infinitive plus the imperfect ending to create a whole new tense used specifically for talking about hypothetical situations and possibilities. So you already know everything. I think it's time to practice in context. I'll give you the verb in its infinitive form. So all you have to do is add the correct conditional ending, which is the same as the imperfect ending, on the end to make it conditional. Unless it's an irregular verb, then you will have to make a few changes to the stem before you add the endings. Hagamos unos juntos. Normalmente, yo, tener sueño, pero dormí bien anoche. Is tener irregular in the future tense? Yes, it is. So what is its stem? T-E-N-D-R. Replace the E in the infinitive with a D just before adding the endings. Now, yo is the subject. So what is the ending for yo in the conditional tense? Ia. So just add it on the end of your stem. Bien. Normalmente, tendría sueño, pero dormí bien anoche. Normally, I would be sleepy, but I slept well last night. Perfecto. Ahora, ¿estás listo para hacer uno solo? Nosotras, bailar, pero tenemos miedo. Bailaríamos, pero tenemos miedo. We would dance, but we're scared. Tú, llevar los comestibles, pero te rompiste el brazo. Llevarías los comestibles, pero te rompiste el brazo. You would carry the groceries, but you broke your arm. Nosotros, casarnos, pero no tenemos suficiente dinero. Nos casaríamos, pero no tenemos suficiente dinero. We would get married, but we don't have enough money.